breaking news, a tsunami is hitting Tonga right now after more severe volcanic activity there.
Tonga's capital, Nuku'alofa, is covered in a thick film of volcanic dust.
The Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano, located in the South Pacific, erupted in 2022, making it the largest underwater volcano eruption in recent history. The eruption was so powerful that water vapor was launched into space for the first time by an earthly volcano. This event has brought attention to the potential risks and impacts of such eruptions on the environment and local communities. The Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano is a stratovolcano, meaning it is composed of multiple layers of hardened lava, ash, and pumice. It is located near the Tonga Trench, which is the second deepest ocean trench in the world. What is the location and characteristics of the volcano? What is the causes of the eruption? The eruption of the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano is important because it reminds us of the potential dangers of underwater volcanic activity. This eruption was more massive than any natural explosion in the last century, and even bigger than any U.S. nuclear blast. It caused local tsunamis and ash plumes that reached up to 30 kilometers high, which could affect air travel and climate patterns. The eruption also damaged local marine ecosystems like coral reefs and fisheries, which might take years to recover. This volcano's eruption has affected the environment and local communities significantly. The ash and tsunamis have impacted the air and water quality in the surrounding areas, which could affect the health of people living there. It also harmed local fisheries and coral reefs, affecting the livelihoods of communities relying on these resources for food and income. We're still assessing the long-term effects, but it's clear that the eruption of the largest underwater volcano has had widespread consequences. The biggest underwater volcano on record is Tamu Massif in the Pacific Ocean's northwest, covering an area larger than New Mexico. Despite its size, it's relatively unknown because it's deep beneath the ocean's surface. Scientists discovered it in 2013, sparking interest in the study of underwater volcanic activity and its impact on the Earth's ecosystem. Underwater volcanoes have different physical characteristics than land volcanoes. They are usually hidden on the seafloor and create chains of seamounts. When they erupt, the lava cools quickly into round and bulbous shapes known as pillow lava. The thickness of the magma, or its resistance to flow, also affects the volcano's shape. Underwater volcanoes can release gases, ash, and other materials into the ocean, impacting marine life. An example is the Great Crack, outlining the southwest rift zone of Kilauea Volcano. The geological history of underwater volcanoes is diverse. Some are extinct, while others are active and can impact the environment. Volcanic eruptions can last for days, months, or even years. In 2023, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano in the South Pacific erupted, sending water vapor into space for the first time. These environments also host unique biodiversity, with many species found exclusively there. Studying underwater volcanoes is crucial for understanding the Earth's geological history and its potential impact on the environment. Volcanic activity is often connected to plate tectonics, which explains how the Earth's outer layer, called the lithosphere, moves and creates geological events. The eruption of the largest underwater volcano is related to the movement of tectonic plates in the South Pacific Ocean. When plates collide, magma is pushed upward, eventually leading to volcanic activity. Hawaii has active volcanoes because it's located in the Pacific Ring of Fire, an area known for intense volcanic and seismic activity. Another factor leading to volcanic eruptions is the buildup of magma in the Earth's crust. When magma collects in a chamber beneath the surface, pressure can increase, causing an eruption. Several factors, such as adding new magma, releasing gases, and changes in the surrounding rock, can build this pressure. In the case of the largest underwater volcano, a combination of these factors likely caused the eruption, as seen in the enormous plume of water vapor in the Earth's stratosphere. While we may never fully understand the exact triggers for the eruption of the largest underwater volcano, there are factors that can contribute to volcanic activity. Earthquakes, which change the surrounding rock and release magma, are one factor. Changes in the Earth's magnetic field and nearby bodies of water also play a role. An earthquake caused the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano to erupt just before the largest underwater volcano, demonstrating the close connection between seismic activity and volcanic eruptions. As experts continue to study and monitor volcanic activity worldwide, it's evident that there is still much to learn about the complex processes leading to these significant geological events. The first signs of activity at the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano appeared on May 3, 2023. This eruption was so strong that it shot water vapor into space, a never-before-say event from an earthly volcano. Initially, the eruption was relatively small, and it wasn't clear if it would become a full eruption. Scientists closely monitored the situation because underwater volcanoes can be unpredictable and volatile. In the following months, the volcano's activity increased. Steam and magma burst through narrow fissures, creating new cracks and allowing more magma to rise. Pressure kept building, indicating a full eruption was coming. Scientists tracked the magma's movement and predicted the likely path of the eruption to reduce its impact on nearby communities and marine life. Finally, on March 24, 2024, the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano erupted with full force. It spewed molten rock and ash into the ocean, creating a huge plume of steam and debris. The eruption had significant consequences, including raising water temperatures and acidity in the surrounding area. But as scientists have pointed out, volcanic eruptions can also be incredibly beneficial for the planet. The eruption of this volcano has formed new underwater land features and supplied nutrients for marine life. While the eruption was certainly powerful, it also reminds us of the remarkable forces that shape our planet. The eruption of the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano has severely affected marine life in the nearby area. When the underwater volcano erupted, it released a lot of ash and volcanic debris into the ocean. This can be disastrous for marine ecosystems. The ash and debris can block sunlight, which reduces the process of photosynthesis. This, in turn, leads to a decrease in the productivity of marine plants and algae. This can create a chain reaction where fish and other marine creatures struggle to find enough food to survive. The eruption can also cause marine species to move to different areas in search of better conditions. Furthermore, the eruption has had a substantial impact on the quality of water in the surrounding region. The release of volcanic ash and debris can pollute water sources, making it hard for both humans and animals to find clean drinking water. It can also clog waterways, leading to flooding and other water-related problems. The effects on water quality can reach far and wide, affecting industries like agriculture that depend on clean water access. The eruption of the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano can also affect the quality of the air and the Earth's climate. The release of large amounts of ash and debris into the atmosphere can create volcanic smog, or VOG. This can have various harmful health effects on both humans and animals. The eruption can also release greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide, contributing to climate change. The impact on air quality and climate is global in scale, showing how Earth's systems are interconnected. The eruption of this volcano has had significant environmental impacts, influencing marine life, water quality, air quality, and climate. These effects will likely last for years, emphasizing the need to understand and reduce the impacts of natural disasters. The eruption of the largest underwater volcano has seriously affected the fishing and tourism industry. When the volcano erupted, it released ash and water vapor into the air, disrupting air travel and leading to a drop in tourism. Moreover, the eruption has harmed fishing in the nearby areas because the ash and debris can hurt fish populations and damage fishing equipment. This loss in these industries can create a ripple effect on the local economy, causing job losses and reduced income for businesses. The eruption has also caused damage to infrastructure and property. The force of the eruption has created new cracks in the Earth's surface, making buildings and roads unstable. When lava flows into the ocean, it forms lava deltas that can suddenly collapse, damaging coastal properties, including homes, businesses, and public structures like ports and marinas. The cost of repairing this damage can be substantial and further impact the local economy. The expenses for cleanup and recovery efforts can also significantly affect the economy. The ash and debris from the eruption can contaminate water sources, necessitating costly cleanup operations. Additionally, rebuilding damaged infrastructure and property can be a lengthy and expensive process. Both the government and local businesses may need to invest substantial resources in these efforts, diverting funds from other essential areas like education and healthcare. The long-term economic impact of the eruption may not become fully evident for many years. The eruption of the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano has prompted immediate actions from local and international organizations to address the emergency. They swiftly evacuated people in the affected areas, provided medical care, and distributed essential supplies like food, water, and shelter. Search and rescue teams were also dispatched to locate and assist anyone who may have been stranded or injured due to the eruption. The local authorities led these response efforts with support from international aid organizations such as the United Nations and the Red Cross. As the initial crisis eased, the focus turned to planning for long-term recovery and rebuilding. The eruption caused extensive damage to infrastructure, including homes, roads, and crucial facilities. Rebuilding these communities will require substantial resources and careful planning to ensure that affected people can rebuild their lives. International aid organizations and local authorities are collaborating to create comprehensive recovery plans that meet the needs of impacted communities and prioritize their well-being. The eruption of the Hunga Tonga-Hunga Ha'apai volcano has offered valuable lessons for future preparedness. The scale and impact of the eruption have emphasized the importance of effective emergency response planning, including early warning systems, evacuation procedures, and communication strategies. The eruption has also emphasized the need for sturdy infrastructure that can withstand natural disasters and unforeseen events. As scientists continue to study the eruption and its aftermath, they will gain useful insights into the behavior of underwater volcanoes and the potential risks they pose to coastal communities. These insights will guide future preparedness efforts, ensuring that communities are prepared to respond to natural disasters and other emergencies. There's also been activity in the Mediterranean Sea, where the largest underwater volcano south of Naples has shown signs of life. And let's not forget the active submarine volcano near Santorini Island in Greece, which poses a potential threat. The formation of a crack on its south side indicates it's moving away from the island. These recent events remind us of the might and unpredictability of volcanic activity, emphasizing the need for better awareness and preparedness. Volcanic eruptions can lead to tsunamis, landslides, and the release of harmful gases and ash, with the potential for devastating consequences like tsunamis and landslides. We must prioritize early warning systems and mitigation measures to safeguard communities and infrastructure from harm. As we continue to study and monitor volcanic activity, it's essential to focus on safety and preparedness to shield our communities from potential dangers. In conclusion, the eruption of the largest underwater volcano has had significant impacts on the environment, local communities, and the economy. The timeline of the eruption showed initial signs of activity, escalation of activity, and a full eruption with aftermath. The economic impact of the eruption affected fishing and tourism industries, infrastructure, and property. The response to the eruption involved emergency response efforts, long-term recovery and rebuilding plans, and lessons learned for future preparedness. Moving forward, it is essential to increase preparedness and mitigation efforts for future volcanic activity. If you like the video, then do share it and subscribe to our channel.